Whoa. Okay, calm down, big guy. I gotcha. Listen to me. Now, those three turkeys out there, they like to play dress up and make believe, right? Now, you can either understand that and use it to your advantage, or you can pay for the damages to the inside of your beautiful car.
I am not paying for the damages to my car, Dean.
I understand. I understand. Hey, listen. Let me be your voice on this. Let me take the lead, huh? Because you're getting too hot on this issue and you're coming off like a bit of a psychopath. Let me speak for you on this. I got it. I gotcha.
Why are you taking such an interest in my case?
What? Because I want to see justice served. I don't agree at all with what Frank did to the inside of your car.
Okay, fine.
Ladies and gentlemen of Patty's, Dennis Reynolds is not a good man. He's not a kind man. He's not a decent or an adequate man by any measure of a human being.
Objection.
She's your lawyer.
I'll allow it.
He makes me sick. He fills me with bile. He makes me sick to my stomach and I hate him. So let me ask you this. Why would I defend him? Why would I choose to be on his side?
I don't know. Why?
I'll tell you why. Because as much as it makes me sick to say it, to have these words come out of my mouth, he's innocent. And if there is anything that I hate more than this wretched prick, more than this miscarriage of a man, it's a miscarriage of justice. Thank you.
Wow!
Whoa!
Hey, that was so convincing.
That was really good.
You're supposed to be my lawyer, Charlie.
I'm on the side of
justice. You're supposed to be on my side.
I'm now on the fence.
Matt, please move my gavel halfway between Frank and the fence.
Nice work, D.